Working all day makes a good man fade away. There's got to be a time when everything's okay. So I'll crack a beer and head out when it's late. When Phoenix cools down from the day, just me and my cat and my old dirty hat and old wooden chair up from the Adirondack, watching the stars move along, picking and singing to the dawn. Nighttime on the front porch in July, just watching that moon sail across the sky. Nights like these I wish that I could fly. It's just another Arizona night. Afternoon comes and the dust storm's rolling. I've got my mind set on a tall glass of gin. When the sky turns orange again and the lightning has settled with the wind, I put my feet up and I forget the day. Pick a few back and I let my mind stray, watching my cat while he plays. I wish the night could be here to stay. Nighttime on the front porch in July, just watching that moon sail across the sky. Times like these I wish that I could fly. It's just another Arizona night. Tonight's the full moon bright and everything's alright. I feel the weight of the world lift up when it's night. Working all day just to get my bills paid. I suppose that I'm living my dream. John Rickard's gonna play. That moon sail across the sky. Times like these I know that I can't fly. But it's just another Arizona night. Man, I love these Arizona nights.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm August Manley. We're at the Dirty Drummer. It's Wednesday night. That means the August Manley Hour is streaming to you live from the Dirty Drummer here in Phoenix, Arizona. And welcome. We got people in the house tonight. It's great to see you all. How are you all doing? Good? All right. Yeah. You know, we've been doing this show now for, almost 2 months now. Here from the Dirty Drummer, and this is the first time we've actually had live bodies here, so it's great to see you all, great to see people out and about having a good time. And for all of you that don't know, if you're here tonight, you get two free CDs, so if you want a CD, come right up here and grab your CD and enjoy yourself. And
For all of you who are not here, if you want to come down later, the CDs will be free all night. So come on down, enjoy yourselves, have a drink, have something to eat. And the Dirty Drummer here has got everything, booths blocked off. And we've got some plexiglass along the bar so we can all be safe and distance and have a good time. So anyway, glad you all are here. And we're going to continue on here. So we've been, like I said, we've been doing this show for a little over a month and a half now. I think this is our seventh show, is that right?
That's right.
Show number seven. So we've been finding the, following the dark, windy, rocky path of the public access forefathers that laid it down for us. Yeah, Andrew, thank you. You remember public access television, right? You turn on the tube at, what, about 3 a.m. and there's Charlie and his cousin talking about fishing or something? Yeah, thank you. But anyway, it's interesting. Well, I'm not a TV person. None of us are. So, you know, getting into this thing has been very strange and different. But, you know, America's got a huge thing with television. As a matter of fact, an interesting fact, in 1944, just about nobody knew what a television was. And 5 years later, America was selling over 100,000 televisions a day. Yeah. And that number has done nothing but, of course, grow ever since. And so it's been truly astounding, kind of like the look that Dana's giving me right now. It's like, get to the point. But, you know, we all have these television machines now that we carry around with us. We can watch anything we want, whenever we want, and get any kind of information we want. And it's a little bit strange. Again, like that look that Dana's giving me.
It does look strange.
Yeah, right? What are you going to do? But the point of it is, if you're going to carry around a TV machine in your pants, make sure you keep the public access down. Oh, hey, it's a family show, right? Okay, I apologize about all that. But anyway, so TV started off with maybe a couple hours, a couple nights a week way back when, and now it's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, with hundreds of channels and nothing but commercials on. So you can come watch the August Manley Hour, and we'll give you commercials too, so don't worry about it. But listen, we have a great show for you all tonight. I'm glad you all are here. We have some great guests. We have Mr. Miguel Melgoza will be here tonight performing for you. Yeah, a fantastic singer and songwriter. And well, he may even let me do a song with him, I hope. We also have Jeremiah Gratza here tonight, local bar owner. We'll chat with him for a little while. And we have a special little, hopefully, guest appearance, if they call in at the right time, from the Reeves Brothers. So, yeah, looking for that. They're out in Arkansas. So hopefully we hear from them. But anyway, everybody out there in TV land, hello, and stick around. We're going to be right back.
Beer from Miller is everything you've always wanted in a beer, and less. It's less filling because it has less carbohydrates and one-third less calories than their regular beer. I don't think I drank all this beer myself. The cats in the peanut gallery polished off a few. But at last, there's a great-tasting beer that's less filling. Now, the next thing they come up with will be electric drumsticks, and I'll be out of a gig.
New Light. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
And we're back. So listen, like I said, we got a great show for you tonight, and we're about to bring up our first guest. And I think in just a minute, we may take a phone call. If they're calling in, are they calling in? They are. Let me go get that real quick. They're supposed to call later, and I was worried about this, but hold on.
Oh, hell. It's the Reeves Brothers. Matt and Cole, how you guys doing?
You're doing great, man.
How's Arkansas?
It's treating us fine. Treating us fine. We're missing Arizona.
Yeah, well, we miss y'all, too. When y'all going to get back up this way?
Well, as soon as everything clears up and we can get back through Texas and play some of the bars down there and make our way to Arizona, we'll be back on the road doing it.
Yep. Everything closed down in Arkansas, or are you guys up and running at all?
No, things are mostly still closed down. Everything for me, right?
Yeah. Well, good. Well, hell, I mean, we're right in the middle of this show. I'm glad you guys called. Y'all look like you're ready to sing a song, too.
We are. We want to do you a song that's coming off our new album, The Last Honky Tonk, and it's the thing that Matt and I wrote called It Gets Cold at Night in California.
Well, all right. I want to hear it. Let's hear it. Tune. When's that going to be out?
Oh, we're hoping it's going to be out here in the next 2 or 3 months. We've got vinyl ordered right now and just got the test pressings in.
Perfect. And where can people find it?
Go on our Facebook, Apple Music, Spotify, our website, reevesbrothers.com.
There you go. Perfect. All right. Well, hey, I'm going to get back to this television show. Thank you guys very much. Miss y'all, and hopefully we'll see you soon. We can all have a Miller Lite together, huh?
Yes, sir. Thank you for letting us sit in.
Right on, man. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks for hanging up.
Well, it's always good to hear from Matt and Cole, the Reeves Brothers out in Arkansas. It's good to know that they're alive and well and kicking and still singing like angels. Listen, ladies and gentlemen,
I'd like to introduce to you, and please give a warm welcome to our first guest, Mr. Jeremiah Gratza. Come on up here, Jeremiah. Well, thank you. Look at that. I got my very own Thunderbird mug.
Figured you had a talk show. You got to have a coffee mug, right?
Yeah, I got to have a coffee mug. I got to pour some Miller Lite in that thing.
Or some whiskey.
Or that. Cheers. Cheers. Good to see you. So, Jeremiah, tell these folks, you are one of the owners in the T-Bird Lounge over there in the Melrose District, right?
That's correct. I'm one of the owners of Thunderbird Lounge in the Melrose District in Phoenix, Arizona.
And you guys are just over a year old now, is that right? April 20th
yep.
or something?
April 20th, 420.
Yeah.
Easy to remember.
420, yeah, that's right. Easy to remember. Well, good, good. How have things been over there? Good?
Things been doing well. Doing well.
Good, good. Yeah, Jeremiah and I just met for the first time yesterday, and that was the first time that I ever stepped foot in your joint, and I love it. It's great.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
It reminds me of my living room.
That was the goal.
Yeah.
I modeled it after my grandmother's basement.
Yeah, perfect, with video games and all.
Yeah, yeah, have a vintage Ms. Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, yeah. Space Invaders, Asteroids, all set to free play.
Yeah, and that bar's been doing pretty well. You've gotten some accolades even.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Phoenix New Times named us Best New Bar.
Yeah.
And Thrillist named us one of the best bars in Phoenix, and Eater also named us one of the best bars in Phoenix.
How about that? Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
So, let me ask you, what brought you into the bar business? How'd that all come about?
So, I've actually been promoting concerts for about 20 years now.
That's right, you've got a business doing that too, which we'll get to. Yeah.
And, as anyone who puts on concerts knows, there's no money to be made in that.
That's true.
And,
I can attest to that one.
All the money's made from the bar sales. So figured just cut out the middleman and open a bar.
Well, perfect. It seems to be working out.
Seems to be doing okay.
Yeah. And so now you mentioned that you've promoted music and done a bunch of things. Tell me a little bit about that. What do you do?
So in 2001, I formed a company called President Gator. And it was primarily a management and promotion company. Managed a bunch of bands from Arizona. And then I started promoting shows for those bands. And eventually it grew to booking national acts to the point now where I'm the director of operations for Stateside Presents, and we book about 750 concerts a year.
Yeah, Stateside's real big and does some pretty big names
and
some things around here.
Yeah, so we do shows at the Van Buren Theater, the Crescent Ballroom, Valley Bar.
Fantastic places, been to all of those and seen some fantastic shows there. So with this whole COVID thing, has that put a kibosh on a lot of that?
Yeah, unfortunately, no live concerts right now. We're primarily focusing on 2021. Working on live streams, digital concerts, talking about doing some drive-in theater concerts, setting up, a stage out of the drive-in theaters.
Yeah, and I know that they're just starting to do that out in L.A. I saw it today. So that's
LA,
a great idea.
I think we had one last weekend at Rawhide.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Fantastic.
It's an interesting concept,
Yeah.
You do what you got to do to make it work.
Yeah, and you also have a company that produces vinyl for bands, is that correct?
So when I became the director of operations for Stateside, I stopped using the name President Gator to promote concerts, and I still like the name, so I decided to start a vinyl record label. And since then, I've put out about 32 records on my label. It's a small boutique label. We do limited runs of 250 quantity, usually colored vinyl. And all of the artists have been from Arizona.
That's great. That's great. Because, there's so much good music and so many good artists here just in the Valley alone.
Oh,
not,
100%,
not to mention 100%. The rest of the state. Yeah.
Yeah. So. And basically, it was a way for me to put my money where my mouth was.
Yeah.
Every band on my label is a band that I 100% money guarantee back, love, respect. and thinks puts out good music, despite whatever genre it may be. I've put out hip-hop, country, gospel, electronic, singer-songwriter, yeah. You name it, it doesn't matter as long as it's good music.
And you've been successful doing that.
So far, so good. Knock on wood.
Yeah, knock on wood. But that's a rough go. You know what I mean?
It is, yeah. I did not think when I started it that I'd have 32 records on my label.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Well, good. So let me ask you something. What is on the horizon for anything? Yeah, let's start with the Thunderbird. I know that you guys have the patio that's open.
Yep. So our back patio is open right now. All of our tables are spread 6 feet apart. We've got mobile hand sanitizer stations set up. We've been working with a lot of charity organizations lately. We made some bandanas that just got made today.
Yeah, let's take a look at this thing here real quick.
So all of these bandanas, all of the proceeds are going to go to the St. Mary's Food Bank.
That's fantastic. Look at that. It's a good looking bandana. So they go into the bar to buy these?
Yep, or do you,
they
can buy get, them online? You can get those at the bar or online. And then we partnered with a local beer out of Montana called Montucky.
Yep.
And 50 cents from every can of Montucky is going to be donated to the Human Rights Campaign.
Fantastic.
For Pride Month. If you're not familiar, the Melrose District is also called the Gayborhood.
Oh, yeah.
So we're a big fan of supporting Pride Month.
Yeah.
And then we've also partnered with a beer from Chicago called Old Style, and 50 cents from every can of that is going to go to the EJI, which is the Equal Justice Initiative for the Black Lives Matter movement.
Fantastic. That kind of stuff right there makes me very happy. You know, the time I spent in Seattle before I came here, I used to do benefits a lot for actually both of those things myself.
Oh, nice.
And the gay community up there was so supportive of me, and it's always been something that's been close to my heart. People just being able to be people, you know?
100% agree. Yeah,
that's fantastic. And then what do you have next on the list for the promoting and stuff like that? You said you were talking about doing live stream stuff. Do you have anything coming up that you want to talk about?
So as far as concerts go, we're really focusing on 2021 for live concerts. Local artist Upsol, who is from Phoenix, is going to be doing a live stream from Valley Bar soon. We're going to put out information on that in the next couple of weeks.
Fantastic.
Yeah, and then as far as the record label goes, I'm actually working on two or three new releases right now coming up.
Great, and is there a website for people to go and check that stuff out?
My record label is just called President Gator. We're on Facebook, just President Gator. Instagram, President Gator. I have a merch store through a local company called Hello Merch. That's where you can get all of my label, all of my records. You can also get them at any of the Zia Records in town or Stinkweeds Records. And then as far as the bar goes, it's Thunderbird Lounge PHX, and then that's the website, the Facebook, Instagram, and then we're also selling our merch on Hello Merch as well.
Well, fantastic. Well, listen, Jeremiah, it was an absolute pleasure meeting you yesterday.
Yes.
And I'm really thankful and glad that you came on the show today.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it.
And if y'all out there get a chance, stop by and say hi to him at the Thunderbird Lounge. Right off of 7th Avenue. There was a 7th Avenue.
7th Avenue and Indian School, basically.
Indian School, yeah. So anyway, thank you so much. We're going to take a short break, and we're going to be right back with the... yes? Hold on 1 second here. Nope, all right, never mind. Listen, we're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back. Stick around.
Oh my God, guys! Oh my God!
Who's ready to do some
eating and drinking?
All right, we're back. It's good being here with a live audience. We have food being cooked. It smells good in here. Beer and cocktails being drank. People are having a good time. Is everybody having a good time? Yeah, all right. Well, listen, I got a special treat for you. So y'all kick back and relax, because we got two songs coming at you right now from the extremely talented Miguel Melgoza. Take it on, Miguel. Thank you.
Of growing old, save me. I think I'm crawling and I can't see the way it used to be. Save me. The night is falling and I can't be free. Yeah. Man at the bus stop looking like he's all but froze. It used to be so easy, but now it's driving me insane. With thoughts of you going roaring by like the whistle on that train. Save me. I think I'm crawling and I can't see the way it used to be. Is falling and I can't be free. Yeah, the night is falling and I can't be free.
Thank you. Now we're all set. I'm grateful to be here. I'm grateful to be in this building, because
Before a few months ago, I was in this building quite often, and I adore the owners. They're friends of mine, and I made a ton of new friends every time I came here, and I'm glad to see some of them are here as well. I'm gonna stop talking, and I'm gonna play a new song. I do need a bit of a cheat sheet. But first, if you got a drink anywhere near you, repeat after me. Grab it, even if it isn't yours. We're pretty much all family at this point. Salud!
Salud!
Cheers, y'all. Thank you.
Cheers.
There's a song about an adult beverage or two and the experiences that we tend to share with them.
One time in Jalisco, I stayed on the farm. The owner, he called himself Bill. He poured some rice and we drank through the night, watching over that copper pot still. This one time in Colorado, they canceled the show, 'cause that blizzard had dug its heels in. So we stoked up the fire and passed the bottle around. Thank God for that whiskey and gin. So let's share the time while we've got it, 'cause tonight may be all that there is, and the only thing better than drinking something fine. Well, them good folks you're drinking it with. Now she roughed up the city with a gaze and a smile, laughing with her hands on her hips. We split a six pack and talked for a while. I've been thinking about her ever since. So let's share the time while we've got it, 'cause tonight may be all that there is, and the only thing better, drinking something fine, fine, them good folks you're drinking it with. Remember that night in the city, you rescued me just in time. I spun out in rain, soaked and gritty. Still can't believe I survived. When I went to see my father, he came to the door. He smiled and said, come on in. He talked about how he wished he could have done more. Now I'm thinking it's time to forgive. So let's share the time while we got it, 'cause tonight may be all that there is, and the only thing better than drinking something fine, or them good folks you're drinking it with. The good folks you're drinking it with. If you pass me your bottle, I'll give you some of mine. Thank you.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen,
Miguel Melgoza, thank you so much. That was fantastic. Listen, we're going to take another real short break, and we're going to be right back with you with more Miguel. So stick around.
Good place to drink.
Songs, and I want to ask you, both of those are original songs, right?
Yeah, one of them's from the most recent record, released in 2017, and the other one is unreleased, pretty new.
So 2017, so you've taken a little hiatus, been working on some new stuff.
That's essentially what I've been doing.
And so you have a new record in the works. When do you expect that might be out?
Well, I think at this point we're gonna release singles. So I've got a record's worth of material, but I feel like I could get more mileage out of it if I could be so brutally honest, to release singles and do it that way.
Yeah. So and you're just releasing those online, iTunes,
strictly
all that
digitally.
Stuff.
Yeah. Eventually, I'd like to do something vinyl, but I just don't have the opportunity to do that right now.
Right.
So yeah, it'll all be on Spotify and iTunes.
Fantastic.
Yeah, thank you.
So, and now, correct me if I'm wrong, but you're from the Bay Area, right?
Sure am. San Francisco Bay Area, yeah.
Whereabouts did you grow up there?
So, I grew up about 27 miles north of San Francisco, in a place called San Pablo, on the San Pablo-Richmond border. So, yeah. It's actually closer to Berkeley than it is...
Across the bridge.
There you go.
Yeah,
East Bay.
Yeah, perfect. Well,
yeah,
very good. You didn't spend any time in Alcatraz.
Not that I know of. You spent some time on the backside when the authorities weren't looking, but you know, that could be a whole other show altogether.
Well, you know, it's not so bad. There's bars in every room, so.
Gotta love it.
Yeah. Anyway.
You're full of those, I bet.
Yeah,
Come on now, August.
So, I apologize. So, and how long have you been here in Phoenix?
So, I actually went to high school here, and moved. I'm 47 years old, so that's the late 80s I was here, and properly moved back home as soon as I graduated. It was a bit of a culture shock, but then came back like 3 or 4 years later because of the economics of the whole situation. And honestly, I've done that like 4 different times.
Yeah.
I'm back here since 2014, and I really don't have a plan on leaving because it's just it's untenable. It's expensive, man.
I
love Arizona. I love the people. I've made too many roots. I've planted too many roots. Made too many lifelong relationships to think that I would want to go anywhere else.
I agree with you on that one. It's easy living down here in Arizona.
You're from the Northwest.
I am.
Yeah.
And I left for the same reason, economic reasons. But when I moved here, it immediately felt like home, and you know, the roots got planted. You know,
absolutely.
Yeah, so so you primarily play as a solo act, is that correct?
I do now. I used to make my living as a drummer/percussionist backing up other artists, but when it comes to economics, it just made more sense for me to do it on my own as much as I could.
Sure.
And then still fill in the rest of the dates, playing drums, backing up other artists.
Yeah.
Just the thought of not having to wait for my phone to ring was really the genesis of that, of this whole thing.
Oh yeah, yeah. Entirely. Yeah. And when you do go out and play solo, it's mainly here in the Valley, or do you travel? Or?
It is occasionally. So I'm fortunate to have a crap ton of work here. Well, I used to work a lot.
Yeah.
I did over 400 gigs a year in the Valley, and it's just been primarily here, Prescott and Tucson. But that gives me the opportunity to go out and do the original thing maybe once or twice a month and not worry about making money.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because I'll just be an addition to someone's bill, and I don't, you know, maybe I'll sell a couple CDs or something, but it affords me the ability to do the original thing. So the day job is doing the cover stuff.
Yeah.
Or used to be.
Yeah. And so when will your next single be released? Do you have a date for that?
I don't have a date. I have a ton of stuff in the can right now. It's just, to be quite honest with you, I could record myself. I got great gear at the house, but I'm getting the funds together to get these tunes mixed and then mastered.
Right.
And we have about eight original new tunes coming in. I have already recorded and mixed acoustic versions of the songs from the Fordham Road record in 2017. It's just no click, no editing, just guitar and vocals.
Yeah.
Here's to no click.
That's right.
Yeah. And
Tell me you did it to tape and you'll get another clap.
God dang it. You know what? No, he mixed the tape. He mixed the tape. Thank you very much. Yeah. Big shout out to the guys at Wave Lab Studios in Tucson. So we got definitely have some stuff ready to release. It's just, to be honest with you, a question of economics at this point. Hope to have at least two singles released before the end of the year.
And is there a website people can go to follow that?
I do have a website, miguelmelgoza.com. Mm-hmm. I got to be honest, I haven't updated that very recently, but the best place to find me is on Instagram.
Okay.
M-I-G-G-Y-M-E-L music. And I post my schedule there most Mondays. Nowadays, there's not a whole lot there, but it used to be.
So let me see if I get this right. Miggy Mel Music?
That's it.
Miggy Mel Music with two G's.
M-I-G-G-Y. Two G's, baby. Yeah, all right. Miggy Mel Music.
Wow.
Yeah.
I can remember that, but I can't remember my own name.
I don't even know my own phone number, Mr. Manley. Cheers to you. Can I just say, by the way,
cheers.
There are very few artists. This is just...
Sorry. Oh, no, hey.
So there are guys that I came up listening to. My dad introduced me to.
Yep.
Chris Christopherson, Waylon.
Oh yeah.
Gosh, I know I'm gonna blank on the rest of them, but obviously we know them as singer-songwriters. But there's music in their vocal and their speech patterns. You got that too, dude.
Well,
like just simply the sound, the way you speak. There's music going on there, and that's something that a lot of different cultures have. But it's very seldom that you find it. So hey, cheers to you and your gift, brother.
And right back at you, cheers.
All right, there.
And now, since you did a cheers earlier, I got to teach you one. And this goes out to everybody out here too. If you got a drink, raise it up.
Come on.
My grandfather taught me this, and he's from Conway, Arkansas. Yeah. So here it goes. You ready? Do it and from it. Do it again. If you ever get to it, to do it. And don't do it, you never get to it, to do it again. Cheers.
Yeah. I'm going to ask you to write that down a little bit later.
Well, it took me all of about 35 years to figure out what the hell he's saying. But listen, I love your voice and I love your playing.
Appreciate you.
And I would be absolutely honored if you'd let me pick a little guitar with you.
Are you kidding? Yeah, because I sure as hell can't do it, so I would love it, man. Yeah, yeah.
Well, let's do it. What do you want to do?
All right. So I know Miss...
Let's dig deep.
I know Miss Dana... And TK are into the yacht rock thing, so
yeah.
I think we should work. Let's do something along that vein.
Okay.
Yeah, if you don't mind, we'll work it out.
Yeah, I'll just follow you. Let's do it.
All right, those are brave words you just said, good sir.
Come on,
let's do it. Remember this thing.
Yeah. I'm gonna follow you.
All right.
But one thing, Miguel.
Talk to me.
You let them know what I'm saying, but you gotta tell me what slide we're doing before we do it.
All right, let's do we'll do a song, do something from the 70s. This is something from Bread. I'm sure you'll dig it. Yeah, just start on E major 7. With you. August Manley. Thank you.
Thank you, Miguel, for that. That felt great. And listen, we're going to take a real short break, and we'll be right back. Stick around.
In After Hours, Rendezvous. When only the best will do. Reunity on ice. So nice.
Y'all, beautiful having you all here tonight. It's the first time we've done the show with a live audience, and I appreciate you all being here. Have you all had a good time? Listen, we've had a real good time too, and I'd like to thank you all for being here, and thank the staff of the Dirty Drummer. Please make sure you take care of them. I'd like to thank all the people that tuned in tonight. And I'd like to thank Jeremiah. Where's Jeremiah? Yeah, thank you so much for being here. Miguel, thank you so much for being here. A big thanks to Darren, Baum from the Sonic Brawl for putting together our sound tonight. And Armstrong for doing all this lovely camera stuff. And listen, I want to do a song for you to finish this night out that has been one of my favorite songs since I was 1 year old. That's a true story. And I love this song so much that I couldn't even pronounce the guy's name when I was a kid. So I called him Humperdinck Comperdinck. It's true, I did. But listen, I hope y'all love this song. I love this song. Kick it off for him.
Song I just wrote yesterday, and I hope that you hear what the words of the music have to say. It's so hard to explain everything that I'm feeling. Face to face, I just seem to go dry. But I love you so much that the sound of your voice can get me high. Thanks for taking me.
Thanks for taking me.
Oh, a one-way trip to the sun. I brush back the hair from your eyes, and the love on your face is so real that it makes me wanna cry. And I know that my song isn't singing. Thank you from the Dirty Drummer, the August Manley Hour. I'm August Manley. We're signing off. We love y'all. We'll see you next time around. Good night.